A warm welcome to Bethlehem Matriculation Higher Secondary School online class. I am Binila, your English teacher. Now we are going for the supplement reader, Unit 1. After 20 years, written by O. Henry. What is the heading? After 20 years, written by O. Henry. Actually, his O. Henry is a pen name of William Sidney Potter. So the pen name is, it is not the original name. For the writings, they will have another one sub-name. That is O. Henry. His original name is William Sidney Potter. Okay, he was born in the year 1862 in Greensboro, North Carolina. In the September 11, he was born and he has died in 1910. And he is an American short story writer. And known for his surprise endings. So his stories, everything will be, there will be a surprise ending or there will be a twist in the story. So these are all the things he is known for. And moved to New York in the year 1920. So he was in his teenage, he was with his uncle. He was the farmist, his uncle was a farmist. So he was learning that and he became a professionally farmist in his uncle's shop itself. So his life, then he moved to New York in the year 1920. So there is a relationship between the New York City with for him. Okay, so now let me go for telling the story after 20 years in a short. After telling that, we'll move for reading the lesson. Okay, so now here there is after 20 years. By hearing the heading itself, what you are able to understand? Okay, after 20 years means after, now your age is 17. So after 20 years means maybe 27, right? For 27 or 37. After 10 years, 27. 20 years means 37, right? So at that time, what you will be doing? Can you guess? Yes, you will be working. Yeah, good. Then you will be married. Yes. Okay, then any other? You will be waiting for meeting your friends, right? You will be missing your friends. Nowadays, in the school life, your friendship will be very thick and you will be missing your friends and you will be eagerly waiting for meeting them, right? Okay, so here is the story about two friends, that is Bob and Jimmy Wells. The characters here, three characters are there, Bob, Jimmy Wells and the Patrolman. Patrolman is a plain cloth man, we will see later. Okay, but these two is the main character, Bob and Jimmy Wells. Okay, so before going to the story, let me go for reading the about the author. After finishing that, we'll come move to the story. Okay, take page number 30. Take page number 30. Go for about the author. Okay, let me tell you. I have said the points here and I'll read and explain you again. Take page number 30, about the author. O. Henry, born in 1862 and died in 1910, is a popular American short story writer whose original name is William Sidney Potter. Already I told you, his original name is William Sidney Potter. And his pen name is O. Henry. He is an American short story writer. His works romanticized the life of ordinary people in New York City. So when he has gone to the New York in the year 1920, so after that, what ordinary people, they move in the New York City, about that, he has written his writings. His stories are well known throughout the world. So every, his O. Henry stories, one more story, The Gift of Magi, everything, it was there in the old syllabus. So like this, it is a very famous stories all over the world. They express the effect of coincidence of character and often have unexpected twist in the end. So the coincidence of the character, two characters if he is giving, the coincidence between them, it will be, it has a little difference, it will be that between the two characters that he will express clearly. And at the end, there will be a twist. So that is a main quality of the writer. The surprise ending or twist ending, it will be there in the story. Okay, his stories are also noted for the witticism and clever wordplay. So his stories, there will be a comic one and also there will be a clever wordplay. So the words which he used, everything, it will be a very good in manner. O. Henry's prolific writing period began in 1902 in New York City, where he wrote 381 short stories. So I told you, 1902 he came to 1920 he came to New York, but 1902 he started to write his writings everything. So when he started his writings everything, he used to publish that in his local magazines. So that from that only he started to improve his writing skills. So when he wrote 381 short stories in New York, he began to write 381 short stories in the year 1902. He started and he was coming up. He wrote one story a week for the New York World Sunday magazine for over a year. So for a year, all through that year fully he was writing for the magazine of the local magazine, that is a Sunday magazine. Every week once it will be published, that magazine in the New York. He started to write every week, one published he has given. Okay. O. Henry's short story After 20 Years was first published in the Sunday edition of the New York World in 1905. So here After 20 Years also, this story also was published in the Sunday, one New York published publications of Sunday, that time he has published the After 20 Years also. The story was included in the 1906 anthology, The 4 Million, and it has since been republished in many short story collections. So his stories, everything, it was published in the anthology of 1906, that 4 Million collections, it was published, and it was a short story collection, it was a book of short story collections, there also his stories After 20 Years was published. From that collections only, here it is given in your book. A few of his other popular short stories are The Gift of the Magi. Not, you don't want to read that as a Maggie. It is a Magi. M-A-G-I is called as a Magi. The Cop and the Anthem, The Ransom of the Red Chief, A Retried Reformation, and The Third Ingredient. So these are all his writings, these are all his short stories, the popular short stories. What are the popular short stories? The Gift of the Magi, The Cop and the Anthem, The Ransom of Red Chief, A Retried Reformation, and Third Ingredient. So this is all his works. Okay, now let me move on to the story. Okay, take page number 27. Warm up is given. Look into that. What do you expect your close friends to do for you? Beautify the petals with your thoughts. So you have your good friend, your close friend, best friend. So you have lot of opinion about your close friends, right? So what is your opinion? They have to be very close. They have to be very cooperate with me. They have to be very comfort with me. They have to trust me. So like this, lot of points you may have, right? Your own opinion. So you can go for writing the petals. There is a flower given. The center it is written friends. So there is other petals are there. So one petal it is written entertain. My friend has to entertain me always, like that. So the other columns you can fill it up. Your own opinions you can write it there. How you expect your friends? Okay, go for writing them. First one is entertain. The second one, if you know by yourself, you can write. Otherwise, you can write what I'm telling. Share, help, care, comfort, advice, cooperate, trust. Let me tell you once again. If you know by yourself, you can write. Otherwise, you can write what I'm telling. Once again, I'll tell you. Entertain is given there already. Share, help, care, advice, cooperate, trust, comfort. Have you written? Okay, good. Okay, now the second one is, find out when the International Day of Friendship is celebrated. Do you know when Friendship Day is celebrated? Okay, recently you have celebrated. So when usually the Friendship Day will be celebrated, how you will come to know that Friendship Day is the day today? Usually the Friendship Day, when it will come, is the first Sunday of August. First Sunday of the month of August, they will be celebrating. So this year, 2020, what is the date of the Friendship Day? It is a 2nd August. Okay, so that day they will be celebrating. So International Friendship Day is celebrated on August 2nd, that is in 2020 August 2nd, or you can write the first Sunday of month of August. Clear? Okay, how is that day celebrated? How you'll be celebrating your friendship day? By giving a long party, get together. Okay, so write your own opinion how you'll be celebrating. Maybe exchanging greetings or text message, forwarding messages, or tying friendship bands. Any other? Giving gifts? Okay, very good. So this is all the thing or you'll be exchanging with your friends. This is all the way you'll be celebrating your friendship day. But whether the only one day you'll be celebrating your friendship day? No. Every day you'll be enjoying with your friends, right? Okay. So next, third one. We have heard of the proverb, familiarity breeds contempt. Have you heard of this proverb? Familiarity breeds contempt. What is that meaning? Do you know? Okay, let me tell you. Tamil says, palaga palaga paalum pulikum, right? Okay, what it is means, what you will be doing when you are having a good friendship, often if you are meeting together, you are not missing them, what will happen? Soon you will be having an enmity in between them, right? No, your friendship is true as you are willing. There should not be any enmity between your friends. I wish you have a good friends. So nothing will happen, don't worry. Okay, that is the proverb, familiarity breeds contempt. Do you think that the passage of time strengthens friendship? Share your reason with your class. So now you can think about that proverb, whether your friendship also has become like that. When you are being too close with your friends, whether they have fought with you. If it is so, write some points regarding that. Okay, now let me go for the story. This O. Henry story is a little bit with a twist and how the people has changed over time to keep their bonds of friendship intact. That is the story theme. And here the characters I already told you, Bob, Jimmy Wells and Patrolman. That is a patrolman who is coming in a plain clothes. Okay. So now here is a story entitled After 20 Years, which is about two best friends who had to part ways. They returned to keep an appointment they had made 20 years ago. Read to find out what happens when they meet again. So here there is after 20 years, there is two best friends are there. They had part of their ways. So when they are departing each other, what was doing? They had a plan. What is the plan? After 20 years, we have to meet each other. Okay, so you also have your plan with your friends. After 10 years or after 5 years, we can meet wherever you go, whatever you become, you have to meet at this place. Like that, they have discussed each other. So after this, whether they came and met at the day of 20 years, whether they met or not, we will see in this story. Okay, so imagine that after 20 years, the two friends are going to meet or not. Okay, let me tell you about the story. Here there is a character to Bob and Jimmy Wells. When Bob was 18 years old, Jimmy was 20 years old. So they both were good friends. Okay. So now they shared each other, they shared their opinions, everything, and they were very thick best friends. Now Jimmy Wells was there in New York and Bob also was there in New York. Now they plan to move each other to the different places. But Jimmy Wells doesn't want to move to any other place. He wanted to settle in New York because he feels that New York is comfortable for him. But Bob is not willing to stay there. He wants to move to the West. Okay. So when he is trying to move to West, he left Jimmy Wells in the same place in New York. And there is a restaurant was there. Big Joe's Brady restaurant. Okay, Big Joe's Brady restaurant was the place where they was meeting at each other. So in this restaurant they was having their food, everything, and after the food they had each other, they departed each other, telling that wherever you go, whatever you do, whatever jobs you get or however you are, after 20 years what you have to do? You have to come to the same place in New York where the Big Joe's Brady restaurant, that we have to come and meet each other. They have planned and they went away. So now after planning and they went, whether after 20 years they will be coming and meeting each other? If you are there, whether you will go and meet your friend after 20 years, as they have said that, and you have to come to this place? Yes, sure. As your friendship is very thick, you'll be going and meeting each other, right? Okay. Some persons, what you'll do? It is none of my work. I don't know. I'm rich. I am the educator. I have busy schedule. How can I go and meet her after 20 years? Whether he'll be coming or not, I don't know. So I don't want to move. You'll feel. So that is a different kind. Okay. So here there is a two friends. They are going to come and meet after 20 years or not. We are going to see. Okay, so the remaining part, if I say this, will not be having any interest in the story. So this is the story, hints of the story. Let me read and tell you the remaining also. Okay, take your book, page number 27. The heading is After 20 Years, written by O. Henry. His original name is William Sidney Potter. Once again, After 20 Years, O. Henry is his pen name. William Sidney Potter is his original name. Okay, now take the page number 27, take your textbook and go for reading the lesson. The policeman on the beat moved up the avenue impressively. The impressiveness was habitual and not for show, for spectators were few. The time was barely 10 o'clock at night, but chilly gestures of wind with a taste of rain them had well nigh depeopled the streets. The policeman on the beat means that where the police will have some separate place for them. Up to this place it is my own control, they will be telling. So there will be a border for the police to have to control the area. So that beat, he is moving on his own beat up the avenue. Avenue means in the wide streets. So the police, what they will be doing, they will be checking all the places whether there is anything for that. They will be checking in their own places where that is allotted. So he is moving in his place, wide street is now. And he is moving impressively, very beautifully, how the people will be admiring the place, like that he is moving down. The impressiveness was habitual and not for show. So that place, how the beautiness, everything, it is not for show. Not for show means it is not for the day. One day show, one day program, they will be decorating everything. Like that, it is not that. It is the habitual, it is a regular way, the place, how it seems. And the spectators were few, so there is no persons to look into the place. There will be, if it is a show, there will be a lot of audience will be sitting, they will be watching each of the programs, but here there is no spectators, no people are watching that. The time was barely 10 o'clock, so there is barely, means just 10 o'clock it became. And how the climate is, just a very chilly gusts of wind, a chilly climate, and the winds are blowing down with the taste of rain then had well nigh means it is almost going to rain. We'll be telling, no, the rain is going to come, you'll say like that. It is depeopled the streets, reduce the population. Depeopled means it is as there is going to rain or the wind is going to come, as it is going to the rain is going to fall. There is no people. When there is the rain is going to fall, what you will do? You all will be rushing to your house, right? So like that, there is a less number of people are there. One or two people are there. So others, everything, they are not coming out of the house. Okay. So this is the situation. You can imagine at night, 10 o'clock, how the street it is. A wide street. The policeman is walking in his own beat. And the situation is like going to be rain. So you can imagine at 10 o'clock how it will be. Trying those as he went, twirling his club with many intricate and artful movements, turning now and then to cast his watchful eye adown the pacific thoroughfare the officer with his stalwart form and slight swagger made a fine picture of a guardian of the peace. So what he is doing, trying his doors as he went, as the policeman walked to check whether all the doors are shut. There is a lot of shops are there. He wanted to check whether the doors, everything is shut or not. So what he is doing, he is twirling the his club. Club means he will have one stick, no thadi, he will be saying. So that stick, what he is doing, he is just twisting that. He is rotating that and he is going for checking on the, with intricate or with all his complicated work or job, he is moving towards the doors. And turning towards the cast and watchful eyes. So always the eyes of the police, how it will be, they'll be looking into each and everything, whether all things are perfect or not. So with that watching eye, he is checking through the laser. Stalwart means here it says about the how the firmly built the policeman you have seen, how the there will be a perfect fitness of the body. So like that he is moving form, stalwart form, and a slight swagger. The way how confident he is walking, you might have seen the walk of the police, how confident walk they will have, like that he is moving. Made a fine picture of a guardian of the peace. So that place, a chill climate and a dark night, the doors, everything is shut, the policeman is walking. So this everything, it is a fine picture. You can imagine how the picture it is. The vicinity, vicinity means the surrounding areas. So whenever I'm telling the word, you underline and write it, otherwise you will forget. So vicinity means the surrounding area, was one that kept early hours. Now and then you might see the lights of a cigar store or of an all night lunch counter, but the majority of the doors belong to business places that had long since been closed. So here and there you can see the cigar light, the light of the cigarette light. When they are using that light, here and there you can see like that. So in the night when the doors or everything or the shops, everything closed, you can see the lights, no? Here and there one or two shops will be open and the lights you can see like that. It is there. And the other things, everything, it is a lunch counter. So everything will be closed there. So only few of the shops are open, one or two shops open. Other thing, everything is related to the business. The time will be there. Morning 8 to night 10, it will be the time schedule means they will be closing at the proper time. So here the shops, everything is closed at proper 10 o'clock. So there is no more people are there in that place. The next paragraph. When about midway of a certain block, the policeman suddenly slowed his walk. So he is moving in the midway, the center of that place. The policeman, what he is doing? Suddenly he is reducing his walk, slow down. So when the policeman will slow down his walk, if he is having any doubt on any person, he will be stopping them. Okay, so now there is a chance for them. So he's slowing down. In the doorway of a darkened hardware store, a man leaned with an unlighted cigar in his mouth. As the policeman walked up to him, the man spoke up quickly. So what he's doing, one hardware store is there, hardware shop is there. The shop is this darker, there is no light in that place. So that one man, he is leaned on that door of the hardware store. And he is having a cigarette in his mouth, but it is not lit up. It is not lit up. Simply he is keeping his cigarette in his mouth. So like that, one man is standing there. So now this policeman, what he is doing, he is trying to go near to the man. Who is that? A man is leaning in the hardware shop. So near to that man, he is moving. But what the man is doing, the man is going to speak very quickly. So when you are standing in some place, if somebody is coming near to you, what you will do? If you are not done any wrong, you will be trying to tell something. I am not the person, I am not the wrongdoer. Something you will be telling to try and justify yourself. So like that, the man came near, the policeman came near to the man. What the man is doing? He started to speak quickly. So the next person is telling the next paragraph. It's all right, officer, he said reassuringly. Reassuring means less doubtful. So very less doubtful, he's telling. I'm just waiting for your friend. The man who is standing near the hardware shop, he's telling, I'm just waiting for my friend. That is the reason I'm standing here, nothing else. It is an appointment made 20 years ago. And so continuously he started to talk. He don't want to stop his talk. Before that he's telling, I'm waiting for my friend. That is before 20 years. Ago 20 years, what we had? We had an appointment with each other. What is that appointment? We both will be meeting after 20 years in the same place. That is the appointment they had, right? Okay. Sounds a little funny to you, doesn't it? So he is asking to the policeman. So some person is going to meet after 20 years. It is like a funny for you, right? Isn't like that? He is asking to the policeman. Well, I will explain if you would like to make certain it's all right. About that, long ago there used to be a restaurant where the store stands, Big Joe's Bradley Restaurant. So underline the place. What is the place? Big Joe Bradley's Restaurant. Okay, Big Joe's Bradley's Restaurant. Okay, so he is telling to the policeman, the man. Who is the man? The man is the Bob. Bob is the man. Where he is standing? Near to the hardware store. And he is telling to the policeman. What he is telling to the policeman? Before many years, there was a restaurant. What restaurant? Big Joe's Bradley Restaurant. In that place, what he is doing? He used to come and have their food. So that place, in the hardware shop, where it is now, in that place, previously what was that? Big Joe's Bradley Restaurant was there. So he is telling that in that place we had an appointment. What is the term? After 20 years, we have to come and meet here, the same place. Whether the police will believe him, believe Bob what he is telling? It may be Big Joe's Bradley Restaurant. If it was a real one, the policeman would think that it is a true. Okay. Until 5 years ago, said the policeman, it was torn down then. So the policeman is accepting, yes. Until 5 years back, what was that? This Big Joe's Bradley Restaurant was there. Only 5 years before, it was destroyed, become down. They have destroyed and they have built a new store. What is that hardware store they have built? And the man in the doorway struck a match and lit his cigar. The light showed a pale, square-jawed face with the keen eyes and a little white scar near his right eyebrow. His scarf pin was a large diamond oddly set. So the man who is standing in the doorway, what he is doing? He is lighting up his cigarette he is lighting up. So by seeing that light up, what the other person could see? The face, or the policeman could see the face of a Bob. So how his face was means? A square shape, that is a square jawed face. Square jawed face means usually the face when we are drawing in the picture, we will draw like this, right? Okay, but it is square jawed face means like this. Have you seen the people, the face appearance with this shape, not U shape, okay? So like that it is there. So that appearance he could see, the policeman could see the appearance of the person. Square jawed face with keen eyes and a little white scar near his right eyebrow. So there was a scar here. So in that he could see that near to the eyebrow there was a scar. And his scarf pin was a large diamond. That there is a pin in his scarf. So that how it was meant, oddly set with a diamond stones was there. So he could understand that he is a very well settled or rich. Okay. So like that he could understand, the policeman could understand the appearance of a Bob in the small cigarette light. Within that he could understand. Okay. So the next paragraph we will see in the next class. Thank you, children.